how do we successfully build machines that are able to reason at a level that's even comparable to what a child can do? That's my research question. Sort of a burning desire to understand what we do in our minds, how we represent the world, how we can actually replicate that. Hi everyone, my name is Jonathan Kelly. I am an associate professor at the Institute for Aerospace Studies at the University of Toronto in the Faculty of Applied Science and Engineering. And my work really focuses on trying to build robotic systems that can interact with the physical world the way people do. So right now we're in the My Hall building. It's a new engineering building on the U of T campus. It's a beautiful building. We're on the fifth floor, which is home to the Robotics Institute, which is a new institute here, bringing together all of the roboticists from across U of T to basically work on collaborative interdisciplinary research. Like many kids, I was a bit of a space nerd. I just got interested in how on earth you could actually build something that, you know, would let you leave the surface of the Earth. And the Challenger disaster, you know, it was this terrible thing, and we just stopped class for the whole day just to talk about this horrible thing that had occurred. And so the next question was, how did this happen and why? It was a terrible thing that in retrospect I look back on and realize triggered an interest in building systems where disasters don't happen. Adolescent radioactive black belt hamsters. Why is this particular comic that I am holding important? It's because I pass it around in my computer vision, my robot vision class, because this particular version of the comic is in 3D. In order to see this comic in 3D, you need to wear these stylish devices. I think I would say time travel. I would want to go back and forward. I'd be greedy about it. I'd want to jump ahead a little bit just to see, you know, where we end up on the path we're currently on. And also there's a lot of people I'd like to, you know, I don't even need to talk to them. I just like to see the events that happened in the past, just kind of from a, you know, a time traveling fly on the wall, as it were. It's the colleagues and the students. Now that we have the Robotics Institute that has brought more colleagues from across the university together to work on joint projects, just the wealth of knowledge that these people have. Every time I talk to someone about anything, even tangentially related, I learn something new that is often applicable to robotics. It's one way that I get better at understanding my own field, which is fantastic. So.